शराब लक्ष्मी, सपनों में तो लेक्चर देना बंद कर। सिड, मेरी सिचुएशन भी बिल्कुल तेरी तरह है यार, रात भर पढ़ नहीं पाया। I was with Neha, dude. वो पढ़ रही थी, and I was सिर्फ watching.
Sit.
Don't worry, dude. सब ठीक हो जाएगा. Sit, listen. ऐसा कभी कभी होता है. Dude, एक साल की तो बात है, अगले साल तू एग्जाम में पास हो जाएगा.
पास है मेरे पास, फर्स्ट क्लास.
और क्या है?
सब्जी.
गाजर है?
नहीं बाबा.
फिर क्या है?
बैंगन.
जल्लाद साला.
हेलो.
आज रात को तू स्टेशन पे नहीं आया ना तो खुदा कसम तेरे घर में घुस के तेरे पिछवाड़े में छोटा चेतन घुसा दूंगा. सुन रहा है ना तू?
साले बोला ना रॉन्ग नंबर, दोबारा फोन किया तो पुलिस में दे दूंगा.
क्या हुआ?
काट दिया.
जवाब,
झगड़ा करने गया था यार. मुझे अच्छा लगता है झगड़ा करना, हमारे बिजनेस में यही चलता है. क्या करें?
जवाहर, कितने फोन लगाए थे तुझे?
हाँ, डेड हो गया था, इसीलिए मैं फोन उठा नहीं रहा था.
तो कहाँ गया था? मैं बताना.
तेज मेरा जिगरी दोस्त. मैं उसको गोली नहीं मार सकता हूँ, उसके लिए गोली खा सकता हूँ. मैं अपने बच्चे की कसम खाता हूँ.
What's up, everybody? So we're waiting for some of y'all to start viewing this session. Hello. Wow, hi. Gulshan, hello. Gulshan Khan 486. Michael Jay. I hope I'm pronouncing your name right. I'm so sorry. My goodness, so many of y'all. Nice to meet all of y'all. Shubh Kapoor. Hello, welcome here. I'm very good. Kuldeep Haliwal. 3152. Pooja, hi. Shyam Desai. Hello, ji. Oh my God. There's so many of y'all who are already here. Fantastic. So good to have all of you joining us today. And before I actually begin, my name is Vrinda Kher and I'm back again. I had started off these sessions 2 months back with Actor Prepares, and I decided on doing the chat again today. But I would just like to say thank you to all of y'all who are joining us today. So nice to see so many of y'all here already. You know, instead of just saying hi to me, why don't you also let me know where y'all are from, so that we know who's joining us from where. In the sense, we'll get to know ki aap kahan kahan se hume join kar rahe hain. We'll know that people from all over the country, or even the world for that matter, are joining us today. And just Pune. Divya is joining us from Pune. Sarfaraz, hello. Mumbai, Sarfaraz, hello. I am also from Mumbai. So Karan, Bombay. Jaipur, Zia Khan. Delhi, lovely. Delhi. Samiksha is also from Delhi. Praneet is also from Delhi. Oh, my brother's name is close to your name. His name is Praneet. But hello. New Zealand. Oh my goodness. Hi. Life of Pratik Patel. Nice to meet you. So glad you're joining us. Bihar. Samastipur. Are wow. Raipur. Are kamal ho gaya. Calcutta. Okay. So this is just fantastic. Thank you all so much for joining us today. So just let me give you a small little introduction of what these sessions are. We're doing these sessions, usually we were doing it with Actor Prepares alumni, but we've decided to also bring in more guests from different fields of this industry, some other professions as well. And this is just in hopes to motivate y'all, or just to inspire y'all. Their stories are very engaging, very interesting. Also to just make you feel ki everybody else is also human. We all go through the same things. There are struggles, but you know how all of these people who are joining us and have joined us, they've had their own little journey and they have succeeded. And a lot of them have started from absolute ground level and have made a name for themselves all on their own. And so this is what In Conversation With is all about. And aaj ke jo hamare guest hain, I'm so excited. I'm nervous also, but I'm literally bubbling with excitement because he's a very special person. I've known him since a while as well. And I absolutely admire him. What with being such a fantastic actor, fantastic human being, such a lovely singer. He's done so much. You guys have seen him in Breakup Sid, Sui Dhaga, Pataka. You all have seen him in Aankho Dekhi. He's done so many plays as well. And most recently, in this web show called Aatya, I'm talking about Namit Das. Yay! Okay, so I'm not going to waste any more time. I think let's just call him. Namit Das ji, oh my gosh, I'm so excited, you guys. Hi Aditya. Hi Pani. Yay! Hi.
Hi Brinda.
How are you, Namit?
I am very good. But first and foremost, it's very important to know whether I am visible, whether I am audible.
You are very much visible. You're very much audible. Let's ask the other people also. They can leave a comment and let us know whether you are visible and audible. I can hear you. And that's great.
That's fabulous. That's great.
You're looking so nice and fresh, Namit.
It's basically the hard work that I'm putting in the kitchen these days.
Oh.
It's the sweat which comes out of, you know, being too close to the kitchen and the gas. And it is a particularly hot day today. So that's why.
That is actually true.
I would have invited you home actually because I've made lovely chicken soup today. And it's great. The dinner is going to be fabulous. But unfortunately,
I'm not liking this lockdown anymore.
But unfortunately, it's a lockdown. I'll only message you and I'll send you pictures of how I look after eating the chicken soup.
No, thank you. I don't need those. No, I am coming to your house after this lockdown is lifted because I have learned, guys, Namit has freshly entered into the kitchen and has been cooking up a storm, at least. So, kudos. So, now I know actually what you're doing in the lockdown. But I generally want to know, other than cooking, what else have you been up to during this time?
So, this lockdown has been a long phase now, yaar. We started off with the thought that it'll get over in like 21 days. But that did not happen. It just kept continuing. And now here we are. We've gone through our journey. We've gone through a lot in these 3 months. The first month was all about music for me. The second month was about exercise and it was about books. And the third month became about cooking and helping my mom, actually, who lives very close to Shruti and me. I help her out and because she's just so tired managing the house on her own. It's about that. But most importantly, I've been doing a lot of music. I've been putting out, you know, these quarantine covers with my guitarist, which people have been responding so, they've been really giving me an the response has been really overwhelming about that. And most importantly, Arya, man, I don't know from where did that come.
Achha, you didn't know where that came from.
Seriously, I'll be very truthful, Vrinda. I'll be very truthful. We were dubbing for it. The whole post-production has been going on through this lockdown phase. Okay? And because we were in this sort of, you know, this cocoon of ours, I almost forgot that it is going to come out someday. And it's not like, you know, we are going to be doing this for the rest of our lives.
Yeah.
And one day I just got a message from Ram saying that, hey, the trailer is going to be out on June 5th and the series is going to be out on the 19th of June. And I was like, oh, yes, I did not think about the release. This was actually going to, This was actually going to end someday.
Yeah.
But yeah, the response has been overwhelming.
Yeah, no, that's exactly what, you know, I was coming to. These are all the topics that I wanted to talk about also today. Arya, first of all, it's been so amazing. What a hit. And it's only been one day. It's been just about a week and one day, right?
Today
is a Saturday, released last Friday. And what a phenomenal response. So congratulations to all of you, the entire team. It's been absolutely amazing. And I am hooked. I am literally hooked onto the show. My mom has already finished. She was using my account, so I couldn't watch it for some time till she was finishing it. And it's just amazing how you guys have all worked. And the cast and everybody in the show has been absolutely phenomenal. Your director, kudos to your director, Ram Advani. I mean, it's phenomenal. It's brilliant. Also, coming to your music, we'll come back to Arya a little later, but I wanted to just talk to you about your music. Namit, you've been writing, like you just said, you've been writing and making a lot of music. You've also been reprising some of the older songs as well. So I also know that, you know, you belong to a family of musicians and singers. What with uncle being a reputed ghazal singer. And so obviously music comes naturally to you, right? But you still chose a path that was not necessarily music. It has inclinations to music, but acting, right? So how did the whole shift happen? What was that like?
You know, Vrinda, I don't think you choose a path. I think the path chooses you. And I think if you let that be your philosophy, and if you let that be your guiding mantra, then I think you'll be happier in life, and you'll be more peaceful. Because otherwise, you'll only be trying to find ways through which you can reach somewhere which is only an illusion, which is only in your head, actually. We all know that, right? Because there's no place to go at the end of the day. And I think acting chose me. I was never an actor. I always wanted to be a singer. In fact, I was training to be an Indian classical musician. And I was in St. Xavier's College. But were you from Xavier's as well?
No, I was from NM, Narsimurji.
Okay. So I thought you were from my same college. I just forgot that, yeah, for some strange reason. So anyway, so we had, singing wasn't giving me the correct sort of signals. And then theater happened, because I just got excited by theater. And I was like, oh, this live medium is very exciting. You have one person saying something to another person, and the audience is actually feeling it. Wow, this is actually really live. And this is so beautiful. If you can...
Sorry to just cut you there. So basically, you got introduced to theater from college itself?
Yeah.
College? Okay.
Yeah, through college. Because it had... because our theater... our college had a really active theater scene.
Yes.
So that's how I started doing plays in college. And before I knew, I was actually working outside. I was doing professional plays. I was 17. I started off as a production boy for a play. I started working outside. And then from there, this industry sort of just engulfed me. I just wanted to, yeah, it just took me in. And wherever I would go, everyone would be like, oh, you're so good. Oh, you need to just keep continuing doing this. And before I knew it, I was 25 and I was 26. I had done certain plays. I'd done Wake Up Sid. I had done some amount of television. I was still doing more theater. And I did not know anything else in my life. And now I'm 35 and I say the same thing, that I don't know anything else. This is the only thing I know.
Wow.
And in during the lockdown, I've learned cooking as well. So
your plays, you said you started off with theater, and that's where it kind of like grasped you in and took you in, right? Sorry, Namit, one second. Huh?
No problem. Go for it.
I'm just, daddy's around and she's ready to take a call.
please.
And Okay, yeah, she's good now. Huh, so, I have been obsessed. I've seen you actually. We worked together in a film, for a film as well, which we will talk about later, or maybe not. Also, I have been obsessed with you when you did your play called Stories in a Song, that musically play. I swear, and I'm not kidding, I have gone and told almost every single person I know that if they have not seen Stories in a Song, they have not done anything nice in their life. Right? So theater, I know, like when I look at you, it feels like acting just comes very naturally to you. It just happens to you. You don't have any training in acting, right? Other than theater, that you started off with theater.
No, I don't have any training in anything, actually. I don't have any training in music as well. It's all very instinctive, Vrinda. And I'm not saying this because log bole, "Are, aapne to kuch sikha hi nahi aur aap aisa kar lete." Nahin, mera matlab ye nahin hai. But genuinely instinct. And I've been working on my instinct, and there's something inside me which tells me that I should be this way. Okay. And I've been trying to sort of make that stronger. That's it. Otherwise, there's no training in anything. I've learned the piano. I've learned the piano on my own. I've learned music on my own. I have. I was thrown in the deep end where acting was concerned, and I won't take any names. But I was severely abused by my first director, but rightly so. I mean, I learned the craft on my own.
You learned on the job, as they say. I learned on the job
while doing it. And you know, that's the best place to learn anything, because you have so much pressure at that point of time, and you know that you have to give it your best. It's not a workshop scenario. It's not a scenario where you will get away. You know that you are going to get paid for this, and hence you better do a good job.
Yeah, but did you never feel like you wanted to get trained
in music? I felt
not in music. You like the process of learning on the job while you're doing it.
Yeah,
especially when it comes to acting.
I do feel that, you know, reading has helped me in acting, actually. And recently, I have been learning a lot from my wife, actually, because she is working with Naseer Saab, and she performs with him in two of his plays, actually. Okay. And she has been telling me her process, and I was like, wow, man, you're going through this beautiful process. And I take in a lot from that. So it's all sort of on the go.
Yeah. And honestly, to each his own, of course. But it's still, you know, even though we say that you did not really take training as such, every time you're there on set, it is a learning experience after all. So, So it's been absolutely fantastic seeing you work, first of all. I have actually seen you work. Guys, he's just there. When he gets his script, it's like down. He's just understood it all, everything. But I just want to know from you, are you a director's actor, or are you one that, how do I put this? Do you ask for improvisations? Because I see that you do quite a bit of it as well, but in your own little limit. Or are you like just what the director says and just follow whatever he's doing? Awesome.
I am whatever the process is, Vrinda. And I think that is one of the most important things for a professional actor to understand. You know, it's very, very important to be adaptable, because you're not going to be working with one director all your life. And every director is going to have his or her way of communicating things. So it's very important to adapt. Like, for example, because this really feels very empty if I just say it, it's a process and one has to adapt. Okay. Coming to Arya and what the process has been here, it has been a completely different process as compared to the other projects that I've done.
Yeah, I was actually going to ask you, because seeing the show, it kind of what we as an audience understand is that maybe Ram Sir has just told y'all that the crux of the scene is this, and I want y'all to go at it on your own, right? It does feel like that as well, because hum jab koi bhi show dekhte hain ya koi bhi film dekhte hain ya anything on the screen, hum pehle dekhte hain ki people give space to each other in terms of their dialogues, they let them finish each other's dialogues. But in real life, there isn't anything as such, you know, you overlap and you talk whatever's coming first in your mind, which is exactly what we're actually, that's what I noticed at least, that in Arya also, aisa hi lag raha hai ki Ram sir has given you all the crux and then y'all have just gone and done a little bit of yours. But I'm sure it's not all improvisations or it's not all your own doing. So how much of input is it that is director's and how much of it is yours?
You will never be able to find that out. You'll never be able to find that out, because when you are going at it, okay, you're going at the scene, you're trying to make this believable. Because first you want to make it believable for yourself, right? That's what all actors do. You will never know how much of it is the director who's pushing you in that direction, or maybe it is you. You need to be open. You need to be completely open. And there can't be any ownership that, yeah, that line is mine. That moment is mine. No.
Yeah.
That sense of ownership sort of needs to be thrown out of the window. Because you are at that moment just creating whatever is happening. You are that empty vessel. Like, for example, in the Natya Shastra also, an actor is called Patra.
Correct.
Right? Hmm. He plays a Patra. What does Patra actually mean? Patra means an empty vessel. And you need to be completely empty so that things can enter you.
Exactly.
Or enter through you. And you become the communicator at that point of time.
Very well said, Kamal.
So that is why that sense of ownership needs to just go out of the window. So it's not you. It's the moment which is making you do something.
Yeah. And just being open to accepting what is needed of you at that time.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fantastic. That's absolutely, that just resonates actually in a very big way. So, I like how you just put that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, you know, you said you started off with theater. It was your college that actually pushed you towards that path or whatever. Then came television for you. You've done a couple of plays and stuff like that. How did television even happen? Like, your first show was Pancham, right? Huh. So, how did you get, or how did television happen to you?
Oh, it was just, I was in college and I was doing theater, and I was known as this guy who does a lot of theater and makes people laugh. And then this one of my friends came to me. Her name is Ruhi Sachdeva. And she said that, you know, my father is producing a television show. Would you be interested in auditioning for it? I have always been that kind of a person. I'd be like, okay, theek hai. Ad hoc, theek hai, chalo, chalte hain. I went there, auditioned for the part, and people sort of, you know, said, you're not going to be chosen, man. They need good looking people for television. They need, you know, and all of these things were said to me. And the channel was also not backing me at that point of time. But my producer said, no, this guy has a lot of innocence. He's perfect for the part. So that's how that television show happened, because the producer really backed me. And then I got into the job, and then I realized, oh my God, this is such a headache. There's so much technicality to be considered. There's lighting there, there's camera there. There are so many takes that one has to give. Vrinda, I came from a position where I did not know the editing process even. Like for example, I did not know that when the camera shoots you, okay, the camera will take different shots of you, and then it will be put in an editing process. I thought the camera would just go from one to the other, and then that would be the scene. That is the place where I was coming from, man. When the first shot happened, and that's when I realized, oh, there's going to be many takes. There are going to be many takes of this, and there are different angles which are going to be, you know, it's going to be captured. But I learned on the job. And then obviously after years later, I came back to television with Sumit Samarlega. And that was a very different phase of my life.
Yeah.
When Star Plus was officially making a remake of Everybody Loves Raymond. And I was the first person who was tested for Sumit's part, Raymond's part. And the producer just loved me. Diya really loved me. And she said, you are my Raymond. You are my Indian Raymond. You're Sumit for me. And I really enjoyed myself here. And that television, every time I've come back to television, I've always learned something new.
So I just, you know what, the reason why I talk about television right now is because a lot of the students also who come to us, or a lot of people who you know, just generally get in touch with us, you know, they all want to just say ki, hame to filming karni hai, hame to filming karni hai, no, I don't want to do television and stuff like that. You know, not really realizing ki television also has a really, really big scope. And acting as such is acting. Whether you're doing it on stage, whether you're doing it on television, or whether you're doing it for films, or even for that matter, web shows. So what is your take on something like this? What would you say to people, or you know, who refrain from actually going towards television?
A good actor is a good actor. Exactly. Be it on television or the digital medium, or on theater, or on stage. Anyway, a good actor is a good actor. The process is going to be the same, okay? It's going to be the same camera which is going to be put up, and you're going to do what you're supposed to do, right? What television does, and especially for people who are not from filmy backgrounds, is it gives you a certain discipline. And it also makes... It also introduces you to that discipline. Yeah. It's very, very important. It's really important. So that's why whenever people come up to me and say that, you know, should we do television? I said, don't look down upon anything. As actors, we need to find a place where we get a job.
Correct.
And if it's television, then it's television. If it's, I mean, come on, yaar. I mean, we can be talking about so many people who have started off from television. And exactly. invariably, you know what would happen? You will see a lot of non-filmy people coming from television. So you have an Irfan Khan who came from television.
Yeah.
You have the late Sushant Singh Rajput Shah Rukh Khan himself.
Yeah, I mean, one of the biggest examples. But that's exactly why I wanted to touch upon this. Ki, why do people... Like a lot of people do have this notion ki no, ye television nahi karna hai, whatever their reasons may be, whatever their apprehension may be. But like you just said, ki work is work after all.
Work is work. Vrinda, it's very, it is very, very important for us as actors to be out there and be seen. And also not put... not give importance to the outcome. Because what I see with a lot of people is that they already start thinking in terms of what this will look like. And that's the death of an artist, let me tell you. Good. An Good. Artist needs to express. And that's essentially what he does. And if the outcome becomes too important, and if you get too attached to the outcome, then you're creating. It'll be difficult for you to stay happy. To stay happy, yeah, it will.
So I really like the way that you put it. That's the reason I wanted to ask you this. Okay, so then one fine day, wake ups, it happens, right? Which, if I go to see, is a film which, जिसको देखेंगे and हम बोलेंगे कि do you remember Namit Das? Arey, he was there in Wake Up and he was playing this one's friend. And everybody knows who we're talking about. What I want to ask about this film, or, you know, coming from films like this, is that you played secondary characters. You know, you aided, is what I would like to say. You aided the main actors, or the leads, as we call them. What is your take on playing secondary characters, or playing these? And I honestly, if you ask me, I feel it's one of the most important things. Our character actors, jinko bhi hum kehte hain, I think they kind of lift your film and actually take it where it needs to go. That's what I totally believe in. But I just wanted to know, what's it like for you? Because you, even in, you know, even though you were playing a secondary character in Wake Up Sid, you still made and held your name there. We, everybody knows ki, are Namit Das, oh yeah, I've seen him in Wake Up Sid. You know what I'm saying? So what is your take on that? On,
you know, I will connect this to life. Okay. आप जो जीवन जीते हो, ठीक है, एक फिल्म चल रही है, ठीक है, एक कहानी है जो आपकी कहानी है, ठीक है, इस कहानी में आप हीरो,
मैं कौन,
ठीक है, आप हीरो हो कहानी के, ठीक है, और आपकी कहानी की आप हीरोइन, ठीक है, राइट, इस कहानी में अगर सिर्फ मैं ही मैं हूं तो कहानी का कोई मतलब नहीं हुआ ना, करेक्ट,
yeah.
तो फिर सिर्फ मैं ही हूं ना, तो फिर मैं ही चिकन सूप बनाता हूँ, मैं ही लाइट लगा के जो है लाइट लगा के ये इंस्टा लाइव पे बात करता हूँ, मैं ही जाता हूँ और जो है ना वेजिटेबल्स उगाता हूँ, मैं ही जाके धूप सेकता हूँ, मैं ही जाके दुखी होता हूँ, मैं, यार ऐसे तो नहीं होता ना यार. कहानी में बहुत कुछ होता है. हमारी कहानी में हमारे पेरेंट्स भी होते हैं, मेरी वाइफ होती है, फिर उसके बाद हमारे दोस्त होते हैं, फिर उसके बाद हमारा भाजी वाला होता है, उसके बाद हमारा वॉचमैन होता है, बहुत सारी चीजें होती हैं यार जो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होती है.
एग्जैक्टली, यू ऑल आल्सो प्ले अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इन योर लाइफ.
एग्जैक्टली. नाउ इमेजिन, नाउ जस्ट पुट दिस एनालॉजी टू अ फिल्म व्हिच इज ओनली हीरोइन. Okay, and no one else. Okay, until and unless it's a story about two people stuck on an island and they don't have anything to do, or it's about a quarantine phase which is going to eventually end for all of us.
Yes.
Other than that, there are many stories which will have many people in many shapes and sizes, in different capacities, with different conversations, with different sort of, you know, ideas that will affect the story, right? So you need those people also. It's as simple as that. It's very unfortunate that the industry only sees the hero, heroine, the people who are there on the poster. It's great. I don't have anything against them. But it's a story at the end of the day. Imagine take all those people away and just the hero, heroine, and for 2.5 hours, people just watching that. That's just... That's not going to make a story for you, right?
I don't think there is anybody else who would have put it better, by the way. Your example, your analogy right now. Like, I'm telling you, abhi kisi ko bhi ye dikha dungi na, wo apne shatr ko cover karegi, bolegi, sir, hum sab kuch karne ko dekha rahe hain.
Absolutely. But, here comes the difficult part. Because when you're going to be doing supporting roles, there are many people who are going to come up to you. Arey, wo to hero ke side. To side hero hai na, side hero. To side pe khada rehta hai na, parallel lead hai uska. See, these are terms. These are things which people will be saying. You have to bring dignity to whatever you do in front of the camera. And that's why when people come and ask me, I want to become an actor, and what should I do for that? I always say that. Live big lives. Because eventually, actors play themselves in all the different characters. And if you have had many, many, if you've had many experiences, then you would be able to churn out so many people from within you and become those people. And that's very, very important.
That's absolutely fantastically said, by the way. And like, again, I'm going to say it, that nobody would have put this any better. Nobody
really
would have said
sweet.
Anything else.
Really sweet, yeah.
But, so, another film that I really definitely want to talk about is Aankhon Dekhi. I am such a fan of that film. Again, I'm going to say another thing that you all haven't seen. If you all haven't seen Aankhon Dekhi, then again, a lot of people are missing out on a lot of things. Aankhon Dekhi is such a beautiful film. It is so it really touches your heart and it's so real. It's just very real, right? And coming from commercial to coming to something that's arty, that's what we call art, right? How was the experience, or is it any different in terms of shooting or playing a character for a commercial film as to playing a character for an art film? Aankhon Ki Khel is like absolutely brilliant. It's so raw, it's so, I don't know, it's so complex also. So is there any sort of a difference you
feel? No. But no, I really don't feel that there is any difference. It all depends upon the director. Because the camera is such a, it is such a director's medium that one has to be in tune with that. It's that thing of I get into a project and I don't get into the project thinking ki, okay, it's a commercial project, meri acting to ab aisi hogi. I get into an art project and I'm like, ke, nahi yaar, aisa kuch karenge. Nahi. It's all about the communication that you have with the director and what the director wants to say through this, you know. So that is most important. It doesn't matter whether it's an art project. You don't think like that.
Well, everybody's, like I said, processes are different. So I just want to know, what's your process of getting into your characters that you get? Do you have a certain, process that you had, or a certain checklist, if you might say? Like when I was in actor preparation, when I was learning at that time, there was this one, for our final presentation, we were given this one list of questions. There were 100 questions, I remember. Jisme humko bola tha fill karne ke liye, one according to exactly how you are. There were questions, your hair, your height, your eye color, your hair color. What do you like when you're like this? And what do you like when you're like this? And then fill the same thing up in regards to the character you're playing. So that's sort of a process also that, you know, I could talk about. What is it that you have as a process when it comes to working on your character?
First of all, I don't believe in character. I don't believe in this thing called this mumbo jumbo about character. कि मैं लंगड़ा हूँ तो फिर मैं मतलब तीसरे माले से कूद जाऊंगा और देखूंगा कि किस तरह से लंगड़ा होना. जवाहर एक कोक एडिक्ट है तो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर मी टू हैव कोक एंड सी के हाउ इट फील्स टू हैव ड्रग्स रनिंग थ्रू योर बॉडी. आई थिंक आई बिलीव इन ऑब्जर्वेशन. ओके एंड आई लव ऑब्जर्विंग थिंग्स. आई एम एन ऑब्जर्वेंट पर्सन. आई एम ऑब्जर्वेंट ऑफ नेचर ऑफ लाइफ अराउंड मी. That's most important, you know, and I feel, and I repeat myself, that actors genuinely, they become versions of themselves in each role that they play. And that's why when people come up to me and say that, you know, what should we do to become actors, I always say, live bigger lives. Be interested in other things. Be interested in reading. Take an interest in life. Take an interest in gardening. Know about the time when the sun is going to set today. Get up in the morning and go see the sunrise. See the people around you constantly and how they behave around you. You know, that is most important. And have a mental note of these things, you know, keep a little diary sort of going, which is, and through that, just keep pulling out things whenever you get the opportunity. Like, for example, again, because it's not mumbo jumbo at the end of the day. I remember that in Sui Dhaga, he had a peculiar laughter. He was this guy who was always laughing, right? And he had that irritating habit of sort of just poking you in the tummy.
Yes.
I knew someone. I knew someone who was like that. And I remember when I was... I remember this guy, and he was very irritating in school. I really felt like hitting him each time he did that to me. And you're someone who just constantly laughs on his joke. They are not funny. they're just not funny. And I used this during the test, and Sharad said, this is fantastic. Add a laughter. You know, just keep doing that. And that became a thing, in fact, and that became the character. So again, you're going back into your memories, you're going into mental notes which you have made from the past, and you're constantly observing. These are the things which really help you in making your character real. And that is what it should be essentially.
Yeah.
Because method acting wala chakkar hai na, wo mujhe samajh mein nahi aaya Vrinda aaj tak.
I didn't mean in terms of like method or something else for that matter, but exactly what you said, ki aapka ek process hai, jisme aap, you try and dig and kind of find inspirations is what we can call it, or even go back to some observations that you have made maybe, and then you start seeing ki what you can put where, but you do your own homework as well, is that's what I'm trying to kind of get at, ki aapko aapke director ne ya writer ne likh ke bheja hai ki this is your character. But then there is a little bit more effort from your end as well, which you put in,
it essentially brings me back to the point, what are actors for? Okay. So you have the writers writing, you have the director who has a vision, hopefully who has a vision and wants to put up the show. Okay. I often asked myself, I said, where do actors come? So actors come on set, the director tells you, okay, you have to walk from mark A to mark B. And the writer comes and tells you that you have to say these things. So where am I coming into the picture? What am I doing to this? I recently got my answer, and this writer very beautifully said that, you know, Namit, what actors do? They make it come alive. So that from point A to point B, anyone can walk. But when you walk, you'll put meaning to it. You'll put life to it. And that's when I said, wow, yes, that's what I actually do. I put life into everything that is on paper, that is still in thought. I'm actually breathing life into it. It's becoming a living thing.
That is so beautifully said.
And that can never be underestimated.
Correct.
And that's why certain actors will do a scene a certain way and you'll be like, wow, they did it so beautifully. Because they've lived it. Because they've lived that moment so beautifully. And that is most important. And that's what happens with most actors. And that's what... When we say, अरे यार वो एक्टर अच्छा नहीं है तो हम ये कहते हैं कि वो जी नहीं रहा है यार वो चीज उसको जीना चाहिए. इट्स लाइक वृंदा, यू आर अ डांसर, यू आर सच अ फैबुलस डांसर. स्टेप्स तो सबको पता है यार, एक हाथ ऊपर नीचे, यहाँ पे ये पैर यू कर लिया, बट देर इज समथिंग टू अ गुड डांसर लाइक यू हु विल पुट लाइफ इन टू इट एंड यू विल बी लाइक वाओ, दिस इज लुकिंग सो ब्यूटिफुल. And how is she doing this? She's putting life into it, man.
That's true. And that's exactly what we say also. You know, even in our school, whenever we have students coming in, or we want them to perform better, that's what we keep telling them also. You know, like really feel it, like really put your life into it. Make the character come alive. You have to really be there. You have to be present. You need to be focused. You need to have those things that you had in your mind just play at that time. Just be there and then just like have it come to life.
Yes.
So... yeah, but that's very, very important what we just said today. It's absolutely... Today, you're like hitting the nail on the head, by the way. You're like...
But these are... You know, Vrinda, these are things which I've lived by. And I think I'm going to live...
And that's exactly why we wanted to talk to you also. Because these are insights that we get from people who have been doing such a brilliant job with what they've been doing. Because... I mean, look where you are. Like, it's amazing. It's fantastic to see what all you
do.
It's fantastic. Okay, so I want to now come to a suitable boy. Meera Nair, my goodness, international director. How has that project been for you? You also composed 3 tracks for that show.
It's all over. Actually.
But how has the experience been? Is it any different from working with an international director to us? I'm not going to make comparisons like that, but I mean, what's your experience been like? Let's keep it there. Mm.
No, it's an interesting question. What is the international sensibility? You know, let me put it this way. They do simple things in a specific way. Everything has specificity to it. And everything has neatness to it. So first there is the neatness in the thought. And then there is the neatness in the execution. And then there is the neatness in how you live it in front of the camera. So it's very, very specifically done. And I think this is the difference that I've felt when I've worked outside in America, especially, and when I work here, you know, because as Indians, we tend to communicate a lot. We tend to communicate 10 different things, and then we'll be like, okay, I think the second thing is right. Okay. And that's our way of functioning. I'm not saying it's not a judgmental statement. It's not saying that it's right or wrong. No, this is how we are. Whereas the Americans are very sharp. They're very, very, I'll give you an example. It'll bring it alive, you know, what I'm trying to say. So Monsoon Wedding, the musical I was doing, I was part of that play. I have been part of that play for a very long time. And I was singing this song, which has a lot of dance, which has a lot of movement. And it's probably one of the most fast, one of the PC numbers in the play. And till the opening, actually, I was doing certain things. And then just before the opening, the associate director comes up to me and she says, Namit, you are a fabulous actor. Okay. You feel exactly what you want to feel. Okay. But can I tell you, don't show this to me. And you don't need to sort of, you know, show it every time that you are a fabulous actor. And what you need to do is you need to be specific. And you need to do the specific things the right way. So for example, if you're saying this line and if you're doing this, what do you mean by that? And then I was suddenly really caught. I was like, okay, I never thought about that. I was just doing this because it was getting a laughter. I was just jumping here because it was making me feel a particular way and helping me to go into another line. And she said, make it specific. Make it, you know, really, really important for us. And that's what will bring the attention to the right things. So communicate in a very specific. So that's the difference that I have felt with working internationally. But coming back to Meera Nair, I mean, she is just one of those really special people in the world, man. She, the way she knows human beings, only she knows them. That's it.
I can't wait. I'm telling you, I just cannot wait for the show. When is it slated to release though?
Hopefully July end, August mid. Okay. I think that's when it'll come out.
But BBC One, right?
BBC One, it'll come out. I don't know when it'll come out in India though. Yeah, I don't have an idea about that.
That's fine. But I'm just really eagerly waiting for that show.
I'm so excited,
especially to hear your music. That's what I'm really excited about.
I don't want to promise anything about that. I don't know how much of it will be kept in the edit really. But yeah, I had a great time.
I'm going to keep my fingers crossed that almost the whole thing is there. Or everything is there. Okay. So, you know what? Let's go to a fun section. Okay.
Cool.
And I'm going to play a small little very quick game. Okay.
Go for it.
And you have to be very fast.
Okay.
Okay. It's called the first thing that comes to your mind when I say.
Okay.
So, we have a timer. Plus, you're not going to, unfortunately, not going to get a hamper from me. But
I have your friendship.
Huh?
I have your friendship.
Oh yeah. Well, this is another night here, could we? Okay. So, if you're ready, let's begin. Okay. So the first thing that comes to your mind when I say love.
Shruti.
Fashion.
France.
Ooh. Summer.
Calvin and Klein. Because there's this lovely perfume that they come out with.
I love what you're drawing to water, by the way. I was not expecting this, but I love what you joined with. Okay, the color black.
Saturn.
Films.
Stories.
Mountains. Or the hills.
Sublimity.
Beach.
What's up, guys?
Oh, goodness, Lord. Migs. Bye.
The love of my life right now. I'm missing them.
Oh, my goodness.
All our work is
found. Oh, goodness. Quarantine.
When will it get over?
Travel.
When will it happen?
Oh no. Relationships.
Learning process.
Family.
Breathing. Most important.
Okay. I'm going to give you like 4 dialogues. Okay. You need to tell me ki. What is the first thing that comes to your mind when I say these dialogues? You have to put yourself in that place and say, what is he trying to mean? Okay?
Okay.
Tumhe koi haq nahi banta. Or complete it. What are you going to say to complete these dialogues? Okay? So, ideally, the dialogue is, tumhe koi haq nahi banta ki tum itti khoobsurat lago. Okay? But what would you say if I say, tumhe koi haq nahi banta?
Ke tum mera interview itni jaldi jaldi khatam kar.
कितने आदमी थे
अभी तो कोई भी नहीं सब चले गए क्वारंटीन में सब चले गए सब लॉकडाउन में घर चले गए सर घर
तो
चले
कोई नहीं था आई लव इट नमित प्लीज एक्सेप्ट दिस इनविजिबल ट्रॉफी
थ्रो इट टू मी
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I have it. Thanks. I'll keep it here.
Love
it. Yeah, very heavy. Yeah.
Yeah, it's very heavy. It's carrying a lot of weight to it. Yeah. What difficult questions you had to answer right now.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So that was fun. Now, just the last few questions just to engage our audience who are here today. A lot of them are actors as well. So I just wanted to know, as being in this industry, failure as if for a better lack of a word what am I saying sometimes even I don't understand but anyway you get it right failure is a part and parcel of this industry in the sense that there are some shows that do well some plays that do well some films that do well and then there are some that just do not go the way that you hope that it would go right how do you deal with failure
the way I deal with success it doesn't affect me because it's just the way both these things should be dealt with equal maturity and equal appreciation actually but the thing is that we get attached to success
that's the problem but then again failure teaches you but a lot of people don't get that
but success also teaches you
of course
Both the things actually are extremes which teach you.
Cool. What is that one character that you've played up till now that really resonates with you? Some one character that you hold really close to your heart.
Sumit Samhallega mein jo character tha na Sumit ka.
Really?
Yeah, it really resonates with me.
You know, a lot of people professionals are also talking about that here as in comments. Yeah. You know, there are a lot of them who are saying you are fantastic as Sumit in Sumit Sambhale.
Yeah, and
but Sumit Sambhale, why?
I think I am. I am that kind of a person. I think I'm slightly that sort of in between, and you know, trying to keep everyone happy. Also at the same time, but also effing it up in between, and then making it up in a sort of strange sort of a way, which becomes nothing. I am that guy. I think I am. I pretty much played myself in Sumit Sambhale.
So that's why it really is very.
It really resonates with me. It is really close to my heart, and that team also is really close to my heart. It's on television right now.
It's come back
on Sony.
It started reruns, and a lot of people are again appreciating it so much. Okay. What is this? What do you feel has been your biggest achievement till date, or has there even been one till now?
I don't know. I don't know about my profession. I don't look at my profession as something which. I don't look at it as a ground where I have to achieve things. I think I constantly go out there and learn things. That's how I see it. But I think as a human being, I think I've reached some sort of a stability in my life where I feel, and I think I've come close to honesty.
Ah, nice.
And honesty with myself. I think honesty and truth is really important, and it's really underrated. Yeah,
it is. You're absolutely right. It definitely is very underrated, but that's a very good thing. I'm sure it makes you feel much nicer now.
yeah, totally. It makes me feel like a good person.
Okay, so last question before we actually leave and before you go. What is the one advice that you would like to give to aspiring actors?
Have faith in yourself. God will have faith in you.
Have faith in yourself and God will have faith in you. All those who are listening today, have faith in yourself and God will listen to you. And keep working hard. That's what I also keep saying. Achha, Namit, jate jate, ek do line nagar gaane ka koi ga doge to?
हाँ बिल्कुल I'm all ready.
कोई भी whichever song you want to.
Okay, so I'll sing a song which I really like, and it's also R.D. Burman's birth anniversary today. I think so. It is.
Is it?
Yeah, it is.
Go ahead.
And so me and my guitarist friend, we've been doing these quarantine covers. So this is one of our we made a quarantine cover. On this song. So please go to my account and see it. It's called Tere Bina, the song from Tere Bina Jiya Jaye Na. 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 बिन तेरे बिन साजना सांस में सांस आए ना हो तेरे बिना जिया जाए
ना. थैंक यू नमित. इट्स बीन एब्सोल्युटली फैंटास्टिक टॉकिंग. पता नहीं टाइम कहाँ चला गया हमारे पास. पता है सिर्फ 3 मिनट बाकी है टू एंड दिस लाइव, बट इट्स बीन सो गुड एंड अमेजिंग हैविंग यू. वी कैन टॉक अबाउट सो मच मोर टू कवर. मे बी सम अदर डे अगेन.
मे बी सम अदर डे वी विल डू लाइक अ सीजन 2 ऑफ दिस.
या बट थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग अस टुडे, एंड इट्स बीन एब्सोल्यूट अ प्लेजर. And all the best for all of your future projects that are coming out. There is Mafia coming out on Z5, you guys. Just wanted to
10 July. Yeah.
10 July. Thank you so much for joining us.
Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Take care, Chinda. Bye.
See you. All right, you guys. That was a fantastic session. Such lovely things that Namit had to say. His anecdotes. The fact that, you know, have faith in yourself. God will grace you. Work as hard as you can. Trust your process. And everything is achievable. Just work very, very hard. He's also one of those people who literally made it all on his own. He did not have backing, as you would say. But it was his sheer talent. It was his sheer hard work that made him reach where he is right now. I mean, look at Arya. Look at him in so many other films that he has done. And it's been absolutely amazing. Thank you all so much for joining us. I'm sorry we could not take a lot of your questions because there was so much I only had to ask. Next time, I will keep in mind that I will have a separate portion just for y'all to ask questions. In fact, what we could do is also that if whenever you guys know that who the next guest is, please DM us with the questions that you would want to ask them just so that we can also have them written down for us. And we can ask them for y'all. So, yeah. It was so nice having all of y'all here.